Namaskar, good afternoon. You are watching PM eVidya channels and NCERT's official YouTube channel. I am Rahul and we bring you the next session of science. And we are going to talk about force and pressure in this session. The most important topic is force and pressure because these are the two words which is very, very much required in our daily life. So in this class 8th session, we are going to talk about this. To educate about force and pressure, to let you know what is force and pressure, we have our guest, Mrs. Ritika Anand. She is from St. Mark's Senior Secondary Public School, New Delhi. Ritika ji, good afternoon and a very warm welcome in the session.
Good afternoon, Rahul ji. Namaste, dear students.
Ji, dhanyavaad. Thank you very much. Aap hamare saath judi. Force and pressure ki main jab baat kar raha hoon, maine jab padha iske baare mein, ye dono bahut similar word hai and I'm sure साइंस का ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है क्योंकि यहाँ पर देर इज अ नीड टू क्लियर द कंसेप्ट सो दैट स्टूडेंट्स कैन इजीली आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट इज फोर्स एंड व्हाट इज प्रेशर.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल राहुल जी, अगर इजाजत हो तो शुरू करें.
अरे आपको इजाजत की आवश्यकता नहीं है. ऑल योर्स, ऑल योर्स.
थैंक यू सो मच. सो डियर चिल्ड्रन, आई एम श्योर यू आर वॉचिंग योर स्क्रीन्स एंड यू कैन वेरी वेल सी the picture of a child playing football, isn't it? We all have experienced either we've played this game or we have seen a game of football. Yes. On our television sets, isn't it?
Yes.
We have experienced, we have seen that if a football is moving with a great speed and the player is about to score a goal, the goalkeeper stops in, you know, stops the way and makes tries to obstruct the path of the ball.
Yes.
And the ball stops.
Yes.
Right. Suddenly you might see that sometimes the speed of the football increases, sometimes the speed of the football decreases. Yes. But it is not happening automatically. Mm-hmm. There are certain forces which are acting on the ball. It can be either forces which we are going to talk about in the session, like friction, or it can be the forces which are acting on the football by the players. जैसे जब हम छोटे थे बचपन में, याद करें या आपने अपने भाई बहन को, किसी को देखा होगा छोटे कार से खेलते हैं छोटे बच्चे, या आपने भी खेला होगा. Can you all see right now? I have this toy car in front of me. And this toy car,
if you can pull up, if you can pull up, please pull up. Yes, yes, I can see pull up bus. Yeah. This is the best way. I can see the green car. Yes.
So, yes. Now, if I have to make this car move, I have to push this car, right?
Yes.
So I have to really apply some external force so that this car moves in the direction which is decided by me. Isn't it?
Yes.
If I want the car to move towards the right direction, I have to apply the force towards right direction.
Okay.
If I want that this car should move in the left direction, the car will move in the left direction.
Okay.
It depends on the direction in which I am applying force.
Okay.
Similarly, I can make this car move very fast. I can make this car move really slow.
Yes.
So everything is dependent on something which I am doing, and I am applying a force.
Okay.
In this case, it is something like pushing, where I can increase or decrease the speed of an object.
Okay.
I can make a stationary object move.
Mm-hmm.
I can make a moving object, I can probably, you know, put this moving object to an absolute halt.
Mm-hmm.
I can stop this object completely. So all this is happening because of the force which is applied.
Okay.
One more thing. As children, you have played with the playing dough, or I'm sure you must have seen your mama or papa working in the kitchen, or probably you also help them sometimes.
Yes.
So if you see this dough, isn't it?
Okay.
Now, this dough is somewhat spherical. Yes. I can press it between my hands to give it a shape like this.
Yes.
I can even apply more force and it will become even, it will become flat.
Yes.
I can change the shape of this dough according to my whims and fancies, okay. Isn't it?
Yes.
But how am I doing it? I'm applying,
Some force. Yes.
Yes. So we have seen till now that force can definitely change the speed. It can make a stationary object move. It can have a moving body stop, and it can even change the direction, or it can change the shape of the object on which it is applied. So yes, as we were discussing initially, that how does the football move? What do we do to make it moving, to make a moving ball move faster? Or how does a goalkeeper stop a ball? We've got answers to all these questions. But remember, children, that actions like picking, like you pick something from the floor, opening the door, you open the door or you shut the door, kicking a football, hitting a ball with a bat, lifting, flicking, pushing, pulling, they are often used to describe certain tasks. And basically, these tasks are nothing but examples of how we are applying force in various situations. So remember that force can change the state of motion of an object. And if you have to define force, force is definitely a push or a pull on an object. When I was giving you an example of this car, toy car, I was only doing one action and I was pushing the car in one direction. I can push, but as I can even pull certain objects towards me. So these two actions, whether you are pushing or pulling, they constitute to a physical quantity, to a quantity which is called force, as you can see on your screen.
Okay.
Remember that force can change. Now, if you see the picture which is on your screen, children, yes. I have seen many children playing with the rubber tires, and how the direction and the speed is controlled by this child who is moving with the tire.
Yes.
Now, look at this example where you can see so many children playing a game. This is a tug of war. Now, I'm sure that all of you are aware of this game.
Yes, yes.
One team has to win and one team has to lose.
Right.
The team which applies more force,
yes,
will win. The team which applies less force will lose.
Lose it.
But what will happen if both the teams apply same force? Then will you get to some result? The answer is no. So there are certain examples, there are certain things in our daily life which we encounter where we see that even if we are applying force, we do not get a result. Like in this case, where both the teams are applying same force, but these forces are in different directions. This team is one team which is on your left is pulling, so the force will be in their direction, and the second team is also pulling towards themselves, so that force is going to be in their direction. So two forces are equal and opposite in directions. So you always have to remember, children, that force magnitude is important, but direction is also very important. One more example, you can see a wall behind me. If I push this wall, will I get some result? Will I be able to move this wall? The answer is no. So whenever we are applying force, I cannot change the slide from here. Rahul ji, can you help changing the slide? If the presentation is with you, can we have the next slide?
I think you have the control powers. You have the control panel. I can.
Yes. We are
now
able
this
to
is movement. Yes.
Great. Thank you so much, Rahul ji. So now you can see on your screen, children, that basically when forces are applied, two objects have to interact with each other. That is what you always have to remember.
Mm-hmm.
It is not that force will come into play just like that. You know, there have to be two objects interacting. When I was pushing the car was, I was interacting with the car. I had to touch the car to make it move.
Right.
So basically, two objects, until and unless they interact with each other, they cannot, force cannot come into play. Now, this is something very interesting. You might ask a question over here that, is it possible that without touching each other, without interacting with a body, can there be a force where two bodies do not touch each other? Yes, the answer will be yes. And I'm sure you know the answer as well, but we are going to discuss that in a while. But before we discuss about that force, I would want you to see and look through these two examples, which are really interesting. Look at the first picture where you see there are two boys, one in green shirt, one in yellow shirt. Both the boys are trying to push the box, all right?
Right.
Look at the direction of the forces. What can you say about the direction of the forces? Both the directions are opposite to each other.
Yes.
If you can see, A, the direction is from left to right, and in B, the direction is from right to left. So remember, these two forces are in opposite directions. Now, if I ask you, what is going to be the net force? The answer is that the net force will be the difference of the two forces which are applied on this box. Now, in simple language, what does that mean? It just means that if this boy who's in green shirt, इसको कोई इनको कोई नाम दे देते हैं, मान लीजिए इनका नाम कुणाल. अब मान लीजिए कुणाल का फोर्स और दूसरे जो सज्जन है उनका नाम रोहित है. मान लीजिए कुणाल जो फोर्स अप्लाई कर रहे हैं बॉक्स पर, इफ हिज फोर्स इज मोर देन द फोर्स अप्लाइड बाय द अदर जेंटलमैन, द बॉक्स विल स्टार्ट मूविंग इन विच डायरेक्शन. द बॉक्स विल मूव इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ the force which is applied by Kunal. Why? Because his force is more. So one who is going to apply more force, the box is going to move in that direction. So if you are given a question where you have to find out that what will be the total force acting on the box, the answer will be that you'll have to find out the difference. So Rahul ji, मैं आपसे एक सवाल पूछती हूँ. मान लीजिए कि एक फोर्स पहले ही डायग्राम में देखेंगे, मान लीजिए कुणाल की फोर्स, जो कुणाल फोर्स अप्लाई कर रहे हैं दैट इज 5 units,
ठीक है,
एंड जो रोहित फोर्स अप्लाई कर रहे हैं वो है 3 units. तो दोनों के फोर्स का डिफरेंस क्या होगा?
2 units.
एक 2 units, एब्सोल्युटली. अब ये 2 units फोर्स किस डायरेक्शन में लगेगी?
Kunal to Rohit. Exactly, because his force, the force which he is applying, is more than what the force other person is applying. So isn't it simple, children, that force when you have to calculate, if the forces are applied in opposite directions, the net force is always the difference between both the forces. Okay, I hope that this is clear to all of you. Now look at the other diagram.
Now I have, now Kunal and Rohit, it seemingly they have become friends.
Okay.
They are trying to push the box in one direction. Now there are no prizes for guessing that when they both push the box in the same direction, what will be the result? They will be able to push the box depending upon the force which both of them are applying. In all likelihood, it seems that they are able to move the box. So how do you calculate the net force? So now the question for you, Rahul ji, is ki agar Kunal ki force 5 newton hai, 5 units hai maan lijiye, aur Rohit 3 newton force apply kar rahe hai ya 3 unit force apply kar rahe hai, to dono ka total kya hoga?
8 newton.
Kitni net force lagegi?
8 units.
5 hai, 1 3 hai.
Ji.
Net kya hai?
8 units.
Absolutely, 8 units, because now it is getting added up.
Yes.
So forces which are applied in the same direction add to one another.
Yes.
So this is what you have to remember, children. Forces, when they are applied in different directions, they are subtracted or we find the difference. When they are applied in the same direction, we have to add to find the value of net force. also remember one thing, that strength of a force is always expressed by its magnitude, but it always has a direction. Force is never without a direction. अगर हम direction की बात नहीं करेंगे तो हमें नहीं मालूम कि force का resultant हमें क्या मिलेगा. So this slide basically gives you a sum up of whatever we have discussed till now. If you are asked by anyone, what can force do? So first and foremost, you should know force is a push or a pull. It may make an object move from rest. It may change the speed of an object if it is moving. That means either the object will start moving fast or the object will be slowed down. It may change the direction of motion of an object. You want to move the object left, right, wherever. You are the master if you are applying the force. It may bring about a change in the shape of an object, as we just observed that you can, if the object in which you are applying force on is as simple as this dough, you can change the shape of this object by applying slight force. I have one more question.
Okay.
Look at this bowl which is in my hand.
Okay.
Now, if I start applying force on this bowl, will it change its shape? No.
No. It can be break, but no, if you apply more force.
It can break, yes. But for that, what do you need to do?
You have to increase the force.
Absolutely, you increase. Now, what do you have to increase? The magnitude or direction? Right direction, you need to increase the magnitude.
Okay.
It has to be a lot of force which has to be applied in the right direction to break this bowl.
Okay.
So it can bring change in the shape, and the magnitude of the force will be decided by the nature of the object. It may cause some or all of these effects in various objects. Now we are going to talk a little further on this topic. These are contact forces and non-contact forces. Now, we all know that when we do some muscular work, as in if you've seen people taking out water from a well, or if I need to push the table, if I need to use this notebook, and if I have to fan myself, all this work is done by some force. I am doing something, but these actions are accomplished when I am touching this notebook.
Yes.
If I have to fan myself, I need to pick this up and I need to move my hand.
Right.
If I do not pick this up and I do not move my hand, this notebook will not fly away on its own.
Right, right.
Like you have a football, if you want to score a goal, you need to kick the football with some force. So
right.
Such forces wherein you need a contact are called contact forces. Specifically, when you have to apply your muscles to do something, generally they are contact forces. There is one more force which is a contact force, and that force is called the force of friction. Children, when you are going to study about friction in your senior classes, you are going to study about it in real details, but right now you should just know that friction is a contact force which always acts in a direction opposite to the direction of motion.
Okay.
Iska matlab kya hai? Iska matlab ye hai, जैसे ये फुटबॉल आगे जा रही है, इस पे किसी ने फोर्स लगाया, लेकिन फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन क्या करती है, इसको रोकने की कोशिश करती है. द फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, बिकॉज इट इज मूविंग ऑन द ग्राउंड एग्जर्ट्स अ फोर्स, दैट फोर्स इज कॉल्ड फ्रिक्शन, एंड इट ट्राइज टू स्टॉप द फुटबॉल. इट ट्राइज टू डिक्रीज द स्पीड ऑफ the football.
Okay.
Imagine if there is no friction, if there is no friction, will this football stop on its own?
I think no.
वैसे हम कभी भी किसी किसी फुटबॉल को किक करते हैं, कहीं ना कहीं जाके वो बॉल रुक जाती है ना?
बिल्कुल.
वो रुक जाती है. क्यों रुकती है? Because there is one more force which is acting on it. और वो force कौन सी है? That force is, of course, friction and air resistance. Right now, we'll not talk about air resistance. अभी हम सिर्फ friction की बात करते हैं, ठीक है? And you all know that we have already during winters we rub our hands.
Yes.
Yeah. We rub our hands, and what do we feel? We yes. feel that there is some heat which is coming out of our hands. Ji. What force is in play? The force, the contact force which is in play is friction.
Okay.
Similarly, when we walk, you know, when we walk on the ground, if I am moving forward, the force of friction is going to act in the backward direction. Magar aap mujhse pooch sakte hain ki kya ye फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन अच्छी चीज है बुरी चीज है, तो हम ये कहेंगे कि फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन को हमारी भाषा में एक नेसेसरी ईविल कहा जाता है, क्योंकि कई जगह फ्रिक्शन की बहुत जरूरत है और कई जगह फ्रिक्शन की जरूरत हमें
नहीं पड़ती है.
जब हम चलते हैं, अब जैसे देखें इनके जूतों में, द पर्सन हु इज वॉकिंग, कैन यू सी देयर आर सो मेनी ग्रूव्स इन द शू, इन द सोल ऑफ द शू, कितने सारे लाइंस नजर आ रही हैं आपको?
राइट.
वो लाइंस क्यों है? ताकि फ्रिक्शन एक ग्रिप बनी रहे.
ओके.
यदि यदि ये ग्रिप नहीं होगी तो जब हम चलेंगे जूते पहन के, तो राहुल जी क्या लगता है आपको क्या होगा?
स्लिप हो जाएगा.
स्लिप हो जाएंगे. एग्जैक्टली. हम गिर सकते हैं, हम स्लिप हो सकते हैं. तो फ्रिक्शन क्या काम कर रही है यहाँ पे? फ्रिक्शन हमारी स्पीड को तो कम कर रही है, लेकिन फ्रिक्शन हमें चलने में बहुत मदद कर रही है. हम स्लिप नहीं करते. एब्सोल्युटली. सो what you have to remember right now, children, is that force of friction always acts on all moving objects. It is a contact force, and its direction is always opposite to the direction of motion of object. But when I talk about non-contact forces, I think this is one of my favorites.
जी, लेकिन लेकिन सॉरी रीतिका जी, सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट यू. आप आ तो गई अपने फेवरेट टॉपिक पर, लेकिन आपके पास समय से 3 मिनट ही रह गए हैं, बिकॉज़ इट इज अ वेरी इंटरैक्टिव सेशन.
घड़ी बिल्कुल सामने है मेरे, मालूम है, इसीलिए 3 मिनट में 3 बातें बताऊंगी बहुत जल्दी.
जी जी
जरूर, ताकि हम वाइंड अप करें इस टॉपिक को. तो सबसे पहले मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, ये एक फ्रिज मैग्नेट है, ये एक यू नो इट्स जस्ट मेटालिक ऑल पिन, एंड इफ यू सी द पिन is getting attracted to this magnet all by itself. So this force, the force of this magnet is a non-contact force. Okay, it doesn't require these two bodies needn't be in touch to exert force on each other. So yaad rakhenge, magnetic force is a non-contact force. Newton sahab jab baithe the ped ke niche, ek apple niche zameen pe gira, gravitational force is a non-contact force.
Okay.
And the third force is electrostatic force, jiske bare mein hum next time baat karenge.
Okay.
To aaj ko agar hum session ko samap kare, force, contact, non-contact force pe hum end kar rahe hain.
Okay.
And I think we are ready to close the session, Mr. Rao.
Yes, yes, 100% we are. And I think जो examples आपने दिए, आपने चाहे वो कार को move किया, या आपने ball का इस्तेमाल किया, या फिर आपने football का जो example दिया, I think उन्होंने जो concept clear किया होगा मेरे ख्याल में हमारे सभी दर्शकों का और बच्चों का, वो काबिले तारीफ है. रीतिका जी, आप हमारे साथ जुड़ी, आपने अपना समय दिया, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग विद अस.
बहुत शुक्रिया, थैंक यू सो मच.
ये साइंस का सेशन हमारा यहीं समाप्त होता है. आप कहीं मत जाइएगा, देखते रहिए अगला सेशन लेकर हम अभी थोड़ी ही क्षणों में फिर हाजिर होंगे. देखते रहिए पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स और एनसीईआरटी का ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल. नमस्कार.